Welcome to another lesson with Ming. And today we talk about the integrals of sine and cosine. And here, these are the questions. Basically, in English, we are asking, what function do I have to differentiate in order to get cosine x? Well, this one is relatively easy, straightforward, because if I have a function, for example, y is equal to sine x, then I know that the derivative of sine x is basically cosine x. So here, straightforward, the answer is sine x plus c. Next, what do I have to differentiate in order to get sine x? Well, what we know is that y equal to, if I have y equal to cosine x, the derivative of that will be minus sine x. So this is minus sine x. I need a sine x. Therefore, what I can do is that I can do a negative sign here, but because this question doesn't have negative sign, I have to put a negative sign outside as well. Therefore, the answer to this will be negative of cosine x plus c. So this particular one, you have to be a little bit careful, because what you need to think about is that indefinite integral or antiderivative is the reverse process or the inverse of differentiation. All right, next. Let's try out this question, all right? We want to find sine of 3 plus 2x. Basically, we are doing the exact things that we have done before when we are using the power rule, all right? So basically, again, we are asking, what function do I have to differentiate in order to get sine of 3 plus 2x? Here, the answer is, well, I have to differentiate cosine 3 plus 2x, but this is going to be a minus sign here, over, if this is a differentiation, I will be multiplying by the derivative of 3 plus 2x, but because this is integration, I need to divide by the derivative of 3 plus 2x, which is 2, and then plus c. That's it. Now, next one, here, we'll do very similar thing. So this will be equal to cosine. The integration of that will give me sine of 1 plus x over 2, and then divided by half plus c. So the answer to that, because there's not enough space, so I'm going to write it over here. The answer to that will be 2 sine 1 plus x over 2 plus c for b. And for c, this is cosine, again, will be sine, and then copy the thing, e minus 2x over, e, by the way, is a constant, so I don't have to do anything with it, and then minus 2 means divided by negative 2 plus c. And the answer to this will be minus half of sine e minus 2x plus c. That's it. Alright, here I have two questions. You may want to pause the video and think about this and attempt this question before you try again. Alright, let's welcome back and let's try this. Basically, what we want to do is to ask the question, what do I have to differentiate to get 1 over cosine square x? Oh, that's easy. Yeah, right, that's answer is tangent x, because the derivative of tangent x is 1 over cosine square x. So tangent x plus c. Now, obviously, the next question that you may want to ask is, what is the integration of tangent x, which is over here? Alright, to do that, I need to do this first. First, I need to show that the derivative of natural log of f of x is equal to this. Alright, we can do this using chain rule, step by step. Alright, so we say, let u equal to f of x, for example. So, du dx can be rewritten as f dash of x. Right? Therefore, in this particular case, y is equal to natural ln u, and u obviously have to be greater than 0, then dy du is equal to 1 over u. And then dy over dx is dy dx is dy du times du dx, which is chain rule. Dy du itself is 1 over u. Du dx is f dash of x. Alright? So we have f dash of x over u is f of x. So this is shown as required. So how does that help me to find tangent f of x? Well, what we can do now is to write tangent x dx as tangent of sine x over cosine x dx. Alright, then we say, well, what? So now we let f of x now to be cosine x. What is the derivative of f of x? Well, in this case, it's just going to be negative sine x. Right? And so the derivative is negative sine x. So what I want to do is to change this to look like the part A. This one to look like part A. But I have a negative sign. So what I can do is then sine x, cosine x, I'm going to dx. I'm going to add a negative sign up here so that the numerator now is the derivative of the denominator. But if I put a negative sign, I need to put a negative sign outside of the integration sign. Therefore, this is going to be negative of, basically the integration of that will be just going to be ln f of x. Alright, ln f of x plus c. But this is f of x itself is cosine x plus c. And obviously for this to work, is cosine x have to be larger than 0.